Hey, Java developers, or should I say Java operations folks? Well, whatever your title might be, glad you're here to learn about Generational ZGC. Generational ZGC was added as a production feature in JDK 21, and the goal of this video is to help familiarize you with Generational ZGC to see if it's a good fit for the applications you're supporting. So with that, let's get started. ZGC, R, the Z garbage collector, is one of Java's newest garbage collectors, first introduced as an experimental feature in JDK 11, and is promoted to a production feature in JDK 15. The goal of ZGC is to be highly scalable, supporting heaps as large as 16 terabytes, while maintaining sub-millisecond pause times. But the primary way ZGC accomplishes this is by being almost entirely concurrent. Meaning that pretty much all the GC work, allocating objects, scanning for no longer reachable objects, compacting the heap, and so on, are handled while the application is running. The trade-off of this, from a user's perspective, is that there is somewhat slower throughput as some of the resources that could be used to perform application activities are used by the garbage collector instead. If you're interested in learning more about the technical details of ZGC, I have a Stackwalker video on that here. As a part of the JDK 21 release, ZGC was updated to be a generational garbage collector. This change was specified in JEP 439. A generational garbage collector logically separates a heap into two generations, a young generation and an old generation. Upon allocating a new object, it will typically be placed into the young generation, which is frequently scanned. If an object survives long enough, it will be promoted to the old generation, which is less frequently scanned. This is done to take advantage of the weak generational hypothesis, which posits that most objects become unreachable shortly after they are created. The benefit of this is that the garbage collector can be more efficient with CPU resources by scanning a portion of the heap that is more likely to contain unreachable objects, at least in most cases. If you're interested in learning more about generational garbage collectors, well, I also did a video on that in this Stackwalker episode on the G1 garbage collector. And I plan on doing a Stackwalker video featuring generational ZGC in the near future, so be sure to subscribe to the Java YouTube channel so you'll be able to see it when it's released. The overall goal of making ZGC a generational garbage collector is to make it a more practical choice for more use cases. And to that end, generational ZGC has seen some good performance improvements from the internal testing done by the ZGC team. Generational ZGC provides a modest improvement in throughput, seeing about a 10% increase in throughput over single generational ZGC in JDK 17 and about 12% more than single generational ZGC in JDK 21, which saw a small regression. While these charts look very similar, they are actually telling a somewhat different story. Here, there is a modest increase in average latency time for generational ZGC over single generational ZGC in JDK 17 and 21. This might seem concerning, a 10% increase in latency. However, when we look at the real number, we see the real difference is actually only 3 to 4 microseconds between single generational ZGC and generational ZGC. Where generational ZGC really starts to see a difference from single generational ZGC is in max pause times. Here, looking at the 99th percentile scores, generational ZGC saw a 20% and 15% improvement respectively over JDK 17 and 21 single generational ZGC. When looking at real numbers once again, that translates to 30 microseconds and 20 microseconds respectively. Generational ZDC's biggest improvement over single generational ZDC is it's much better at avoiding allocation stalls. A situation where the allocation rate is so high, ZDC is unable to free up memory fast enough for the new objects to be allocated. To see this issue, we need to switch to a new use case of Apache Cassandra, which could experience this issue under heavy load. Looking at the 99.999th percentile or 59th percentile, we see where this allocation stall issue happens in single generational ZGC. Up until 75 clients, the max pause time story between generational ZGC and single generational ZGC is more or less the same. However, beyond that, single generational ZGC starts to experience an allocation stall issue, causing its max pause times to increase substantially, while generational ZGC gives consistent pause times up through 275 concurrent clients. If you're interested in learning more on allocation stalls in single generational ZGC, check out Eric Osterlund's JVM Language Summit talk on generational ZGC, where he covers this topic at the start of his presentation. So the big story with generational ZGC is you're getting more or less the same average super fast latency you've come to expect from single generational ZGC, a modest improvement in throughput, but potentially huge improvements in max pause times, particularly when under heavy load. Of course, these test cases are only test cases. We'll take a look at how to measure performance later in the video, as you will want to see how your applications perform when using generational ZGC, as ultimately what matters for you is if your application meets your performance goals, not the results of our internal testing. As mentioned in the intro, generational ZGC was added in JDK 21. So you will need to make sure you're on JDK version 21 or later if you're watching this in the future. Updating ZGC to be generational was actually a pretty substantial change to ZGC, which you can read about in JEP 439, or you can wait until my Stackwalker episode on it, where I will go into depth on these changes. However, because of this, the ZGC team set up a transition period. Currently, single generational ZGC is a default implementation when using the Z garbage collector. To use generational ZGC requires passing both plus use ZGC and plus Z generational. The plan is to make generational ZGC the default and eventually only implementation of ZGC, with single generational ZGC being deprecated and then removed, though the exact timeline for each of these steps has not been set in stone yet. A design goal for ZGC was for it to be largely self-tuning. Ideally, users should only need to set max heap size and let ZGC, through its internal heuristics, adjust to provide the best performance. This remains true even for generational ZGC. However, along with max heap, one other argument to strongly consider setting is soft max heap size. Soft max heap size sets a soft cap that ZGC tries to operate within. ZGC will only use more than a soft limit if that is needed to prevent the application from stalling and waiting for the GC to reclaim memory. So you can set an application with a max heap of 5 gigabytes and a soft max heap of 4 gigabytes. If ZGC does exceed the soft max heap size, it will attempt to get back under it and return that memory to the operating system. Since many applications experience spikes in activity, this can be a better way of managing those spikes, rather than simply setting max heap alone for those max usage scenarios. If your primary concern is minimizing latency, here are a few configurations worth considering. By default, ZGC will return unused memory to the operating system above the amount set for minimum heap size, XMS. You might consider setting minimum heap size and max heap size to the same value, as there can be latency associated with returning memory to the operating system. Alternatively, returning memory could be disabled with negative Z uncommit, or the delay to return unused memory configured with Z uncommit delay, with the value being in seconds and the default is 300 seconds. Finally, on latency, there is also enabling always pre-touch, which moves preparation of the heap to during startup. There are some more advanced configuration options worth considering depending upon your use case, which I'll discuss later, but next we need to cover how to measure GC performance, because how else will you know if generational ZGC is a good fit for your use cases, or these tuning configuration changes are having the intended impact? For collecting diagnostic information about GC performance, there are two primary options, GC logging and JDK Flight Recorder, or JFR for short. GC logging can be enabled with the log argument and providing the tags you want to have captured. If you want to capture GC logging statements and send them to a logging file for evaluation, it can be done with log:gc and the name of the log file, here, gen-zdc.log. This command would send logging statements only tagged with GC to the file gen-zdc-log. For more extensive GC logging, consider using gstar. This would send any logging statement with a GC tag to the log file. A benefit of this setting is the JVM will also print out a table of GC statistics on VM exit. Note, this could have performance impacts. JFR is another amazing and sadly all too often overlooked tool. JFR can be enabled in a number of ways, but for the purposes of evaluating a garbage collector, you will likely want to do it at startup with start flight recording. Start flight recording can take a few options. Notable for this would be the name of the file recording and settings. This example would set JFR to send output to the file gen-zdc.jfr located in the directory the Java command was executed from, and it would be using the profile settings. JFR comes with two settings files, default, which has a sub 1% overhead, and profile settings, which has a little higher overhead but still sub 2%. Custom settings can be used as well, but that's a topic for another time. Once we have a recording, we can use JDK Mission Control to provide in-depth analysis of what is happening within the JVM. It has multiple tabs devoted to exploring GC behavior, which is great for evaluating GCs. Ultimately, you will need to compare recordings between applications using your current GC choice and generational GDC to see what best meets your performance goals. For more information on ZGC, be sure to check out the GC tuning guide. There's a lot of great information on, well, tuning garbage collectors there. There's also the ZGC wiki, which also provides some more in-depth info on the more advanced DC tuning options I mentioned earlier. For ongoing development of ZGC and other JDK projects, be sure to check out the OpenJDK mailing list, as well as dev.java and inside.java for more information on garbage collectors and many other Java topics. If you liked this video, share it with your friends. If you didn't like this video, share it with your enemies. Also, be sure to leave a comment if you have any other questions or suggestions. Until then, happy coding!